I hear you're adding a new Infinity LC to your lab. Congratulations. I'm sure you're looking forward to the improved productivity and data quality this instrument will bring to your workflow. My friend Chris recently purchased the Infinity LC as well. Chris is a great researcher, but to be honest, he can also be a bit unorganized. He forgot to prep his lab for his new LC and delayed installation by 2 months. He then proceeded to change the configuration of the stacks and created an unstable environment, leading him with terrible results. We know you aren't like Chris, but to help ensure a flawless installation process, Chris and I are going to walk you through some of his very embarrassing mistakes. For starters, instead of preparing his space for the new LC, Chris decided to spend his time building a custom bench. Unfortunately, Chris is a terrible craftsman, and not only did he forget to account for the special requirements, he didn't make sure his bench could support his new instrument. Here's a much better way to select the placement for your new device. Your new LC can be placed on almost any desk or lab bench. There are a few things you will need to consider before selecting the perfect location for your new instrument. Most modules require a minimum of 2.5 centimeters on either side of the LC and about 8 centimeters in the rear for air circulation and electric connections. Depending on your stacking configuration, your unit's total height could be over 1 meter. Plus, you'll need to leave ample space for your solvents. We'll talk more about the stacking configurations a little later, but for now, make sure your preferred locations for the module allows plenty of room for the module to fit at its tallest. Also, don't forget this instrument can be heavy. Be sure to select a bench or desk that can bear the total weight of the module. You can find the exact dimensions and weight for each instrument in the site prep checklist. Chris hadn't even thought about a designated computer for his LC until it came time for his installation appointment, right before his Agilent field service engineer arrived. A panicked Chris remembered there was an old PC sitting in the mailroom that hadn't been used in years. He knew no one would miss it and tried setting it up for his LC. Unsurprisingly, he was unable to properly install the software. Here's how you can prepare for computer integration. In order for your FSE to complete your LC installation, you must have a designated computer ready where the appropriate software will be installed during your appointment. When selecting the computer that will be designated for your LC, you will need to make sure the PC meets the software specifications detailed in these tables. You can find these tables and more information on software requirements in the Software Site Prep Checklist. Once you have identified the PC you will use, navigate to the link supplied by Agilent in your software prep guide and download and run the software installation site preparation tool. Once the discovery process is finished, the site prep tool will display your results. If any section on this report is listed in red or yellow, further action is required. Make sure to set aside bench space for the computer where it can be accessed easily. Select a location where there are appropriate electrical outlets and network ports available. A computer and monitor can safely share a power strip. However, any additional draws on the power supply are not recommended. Have your sales order information, including software authorization codes, software licenses, or software certificates available during the installation process, along with the necessary software media. Don't forget to have a backup and recovery plan for your system. You may also want a system or network administrator available during the computer integration process if you intend to have the system connect to your intranet. Between work, his family, and his newfound woodworking hobby, Chris doesn't have a whole lot of free time. That's why he had the brilliant idea of creating a lab that doubles as a sauna. While this dual-purpose environment helps Chris relax during his break time, it makes it nearly impossible for his LC to properly operate with the drastic fluctuations in temperature and humidity. To avoid Chris's very obvious mistake, let's discuss the proper environmental conditions for your lab. Your LC can be impacted by any source of heat or cold, including direct sunlight and heating or cooling from nearby vents or outlets. It is important to consider the ambient temperature conditions in your lab and keep the environment stable for optimum performance. Agilent has detailed the optimum temperature and humidity ranges for each instrument in your site prep materials. Be sure to consult the environmental conditions sections of that document to create the perfect environment for your device. By now, you may be under the impression that Chris never opened his site prep checklist. That's because he didn't. After the installation, he rearranged his device so the solvent cabinet was on the very bottom and the pump was on top. He said it was better for the flow of the room. Anyway, he also didn't properly fit the instruments together. Needless to say, this didn't end well. you have a number of safe stacking options. Let's go through a few of the most common configurations now. The following configurations are possible: the InfinityLab FlexBench, an easy, adjustable, and maneuverable way for you to configure your instrument to suit your needs anywhere in the lab. Then there is the single stack configuration. This includes a maximum of 4 modules in a bench rack or directly on the bench. Or there is a 2 stacks configuration that can stand on a bench rack or directly on the bench. If you have limited space in your lab, the single stack configuration is recommended. One additional module can be stacked on top of the sampler in this configuration. If you are adding more than 4 modules, we recommend the 2 stack configuration, like the one shown here. Chris did not have enough available outlets to designate a single outlet for each module in his LC, so he added a power strip to his setup and plugged all his devices into it. But he still needed an outlet for his computer, so he added a second power strip. Since he had a few more available outlets, he added a sound machine and a fountain to his desk to, you know, add to that spa-like ambience. This worked for about 20 minutes. Then he tripped the circuit for his entire building. Avoiding Chris's power consumption mistake is easy. Install your LC in an area where each module can have its own dedicated power socket. Remember to leave an outlet for the computer and monitor. If necessary, a power strip can be utilized, but you will want to be sure the total power drawn does not exceed the wattage of the outlet. For example, you will not want to add a printer to the same power strip with a computer and monitor. You'll also want to calculate the heat dissipation using this equation to make sure the heat put off by the power socket does not affect the temperature near the device. For the precise voltage requirements for your instrument, refer to the power consumption section of your site prep materials. Chris also went the cheap route for his solvents. He didn't buy HPLC-grade materials. His low-grade solvents wreaked havoc on his instruments and slowed down his experiments. Agilent recommends that you have available HPLC-grade acetonitrile and water with a dry residue below 1 part per million or MS-grade solvents for your LC. Isopropanol is also recommended for cleaning and storage. Here we are pouring water, but you want to make sure to use a vent hood when pouring solvents in your lab. It's a good thing Chris saved a few bucks on his solvents and operating supplies. Shortly after he installed his LC, his liquid waste that was supposed to filter into the waste container beneath his module ended up on the floor. He slipped and broke his foot. On top of his hospital bills, he also ended up with a hefty fine for not properly disposing of the residue. The potentially hazardous exhaust of evaporated solvent and sample must not be allowed to enter the laboratory atmosphere. Agilent sells a line of InfinityLab Stay Safe caps, bottlehead assemblies with an absorbent to capture vapors. There are also equivalent solutions for capturing solvent vapors from other manufacturers. Any appropriate accessory, like solvent filters, should be disposed according to local environmental requirements. If you're using a mass spectrometer with your LC, additional steps need to be taken. Refer to your site prep guide for specific information related to your configuration, which can be found on your My Orders page. Since Chris is actually a pretty good researcher, he did remember to have all his tubing, vials, and other operating supplies on hand to begin working as soon as his LC was installed. Agilent offers a full line of consumables, accessories, and laboratory operating supplies for your new LC. For a one-stop shop of all your columns and supplies, visit this site before your engineer is scheduled to arrive. We hope this video has helped you prepare your lab for your new LC. If you have any additional questions about preparing your site for your new LC, please contact your Agilent sales or service team.